How much coffee do you drink a day? With or without sugar? With less or more milk? Decision is all yours. After oil, coffee is the second best-selling good in the world. But why we love coffee so much? When you're awakening, chemical called adenosine slowly builds up in your brain. It binds to your receptors that slow down brain activity. The more you're awake, the more adenosine affects your brain, and you're getting tired and sleepy. And that makes sense, because more time passes since your last sleep, the sleepier you are, and will possibly go back to sleep in order to restore the brain and process the day. Then, your brain cleans of adenosine, making you feel fresh and concentrated for the next day. By coincidence, caffeine in your coffee is incredibly similar to adenosine. After taking your daily dose of coffee, caffeine will find a way to your brain through the bloodstream and will begin to attach to the receptors of adenosine and take their place. Caffeine does not have the properties of adenosine and does not slow down brain. It suppresses tiredness and wish to sleep. But after a long period of time and consumption of caffeine, the brain responds by producing even more adenosine receptors, which means that we need more caffeine to obtain desired effect of wakefulness. If you would stop drinking coffee, some period you would feel even more tired than you would if you never ever consumed beverages containing caffeine. Caffeine does not stop there. It also stimulates the release of adrenaline. Adrenaline increases your heart rate, blood flow, and spread your airways. Furthermore, it increases the number of dopamine in your brain, which makes you happy. In fact, it works similar to cocaine. But cocaine works at much more higher level and produces much more dopamine in your brain, since it's illegal drug and creates a much stronger effect compared to caffeine. This stimulation of dopamine led to the addiction of caffeine, but is coffee harmful and whether it can lead to deadly effects? Actually, limit exists. It is around 150 mg of caffeine per 1 kg of your body. Which means, if you have 70 kilograms, you would need 10,500 milligrams to overdose of coffee. For comparison, the average cup of coffee contains 150 milligrams of caffeine. It is necessary to drink about 17 cups of coffee to overdose, and all 17 cups of coffee should be drunk at once, which is not physically possible to achieve because it cannot fit in your stomach and your body would throw up after 10 to 15 cups. So, the conclusion, do not attempt to kill yourself with coffee because it's not possible. And finally, if you're wondering how long effects last after drinking a cup of coffee, after 6 hours in your body will be about 75 milligrams. Effect will be cut in half. While after another 6 hours, it will drop to 37.5 milligrams. So you may again reach for another cup to add your daily dose of caffeine. If you feel tired, hop onto your kitchen and cook yourself a cup of coffee. But do not forget that at the end of busy day, get a nice night's sleep. I hope you heard something interesting in this video. If you feel that this would be interesting to other people, like and share this clip on your social networks, and doing so you will help us in making videos like this. Thank you for your time.